everyone. Feels great to have you back. So then, did you all hear about that Arasaka aircraft carrier docked in Night City? Called Kujira, or the Whale. Apparently the Corp figured it wasn't safe in Japanese waters. Afraid some local fishermen might harpoon it for scientific research. But honestly, it's quite the power move. Wonder what Motec will respond with. Maybe Myers will fly a Rust Bucket B-17 Flying Fortress over Arasaka HQ. Ooh, man, that is insensitive. I am so sorry, where are my manners? President Myers, I mean, of course, gotta respect the office. Anywho...
Thank you. Looking a little put out there, Input. Interest you in a preem, BD? Look,
sure.
He's speechless.
Can I go?
Hold it. House rules first. There will be severe penalties for any unauthorized recording. No drugs, no groping.
Someone catch your eye? You do not grab them. You find them in the catalog, ask for a BD, and get yourself a box.
I really look that green to you. Like I don't know.
Mm-hmm. Doors open.
Have fun.
Welcome to Lizzie's.
What'll it be?
Just like you said.
Uh-huh. They're making waves in Tokyo City and Paris. The next stop is on your door.
hear, Stat?
So, what can a horny girl like me do for a hunting guy?
Something up.
When was the last time I fucked anything up, huh?
Seriously? How far back do you want me to go?
This one. On the other side.
Hey. Get you something. So, curious. The name Lizzie's. Is that the owner?
Not for a long while, no. And it's none too sweet a story.
Now I'm just flat interested.
Real Lizzie ran a strip joint out of this place back in the day. Lizzie's Bar. Girls were paid right, insured, even had decent security. Good spot, all in all.
Let me guess. It didn't last?
No. Tiger Claws took care of that. Tiger beat one of Lizzie's girls real bad ones. No hesitation, Lizzie blasted the guy's balls off. Gang came back the next day. Liz was done.
Tigers gave this place up to the Mox in the end, though, didn't they?
Sort of. The Moxes had to make a deal with them. Luckily, they kept their heads, organized quick. Big boss now is Susie Q. But the sign stayed up, out of respect. And biz booms to this day.
What's on the menu? I'm looking for Evelyn Parker. You know if she's here?
Who's asking?
Big tip. Generous when I get the answers I'm looking for.
Appreciate the gesture, truly. But afraid I don't get paid to talk. Opposite, actually.
It's all right, Mateo. Just waiting for this one. Evelyn Parker. I knew it was you as soon as you walked in.
Sense on? Only tequila I drink. How would you know?
I like to know everything about the people I work with. Either that or it was just a lucky guess. V?
Mind if we talk about the job? Heard you got something for me.
But not here. Come with me. We'll be in the lounge, Mateo. Anyone asks, we're not here. Dex had a load to say about you. Called you professional, effective, and trustworthy. I hope he wasn't overselling.
I'm good at what I do. Got a solid crew on my back, too. Never once botched a job.
You do realize I expect more of you than scraping street corner data terms. Much, much more.
I'm the best, and I know what I'm getting into. Dex is clear. The job's high risk.
By the way, you work together long? You and Dex?
Just started working with him, in fact.
I've heard there are two kinds of fixers. Those with stable crews on long contracts and short leashes. Loyalty and predictability they value above all else. Then there's the other kind. Dex's kind.
Come on. Can't leave that hanging.
Headhunters. They lay their trust elsewhere, not in people, but in a thing. Their intuition. They bet on potential. And if they lose that bet, it's the last mistake they ever make. I'm hoping Dex's intuition has served him well in this case.
Let's cut to the chase. What do you got for me?
Your target. I trust you know what it is.
Relic. Secure your soul trinket. Key tech in the program, actually. We're tangling with Arisaka, making this heist one dangerous, risky motherfucker.
Mm-hmm. Arisaka's poured billions into personality transfer technology. But me, I just want the data on this one. The chip is tucked away inside Compeki Plaza, the hotel. You ever been?
You know, just never rolled through that neighborhood.
Damn shame. The fresh they serve is sinfully good. Chef must have made a deal with the devil.
So where's this chip hiding exactly?
In a suite on the top floor. The room's occupied by Yorinobu Arisaka.
Yorinobu Arisaka? He's in town?
Don't you read the scream sheets? The media couldn't get enough of Yori coming to Night City. It was all over the headlines. Anyway, he's heir apparent to the Arisaka Empire. Saburo Arasaka's only surviving son.
What? So Arisaka Jr.'s planning to grab the reins while in Night City?
Only a handful of people in Night City know what the Arasaka's real plans are.
Telling me you're one of them? Top dog like Yorinobu's bound to have an army on call. Hotel's probably a goddamn fortress by now, too.
Yorinobu keeps exactly no hustle around. Not one guard. Got rid of them a long time ago.
Huh. Why is that?
Surely you know what they say about Arisaka Intel. Sneeze in Night City, and a blossom drops from a cherry tree in Tokyo. Yorinobu was convinced his Arisaka security detail reported directly to his father.
Look, if you've got any spare aces up your sleeve, now's the time to show them.
Now, this should make your prick perk up. Yorinobu recently swiped the chip from an Arisaka laboratory. He's made a deal with Netwatch. Aims to sell it to them. Have you spotted my ace yet, or do I need to spell things out?
So what's Yorinobu due to walk away with?
Unimportant. You focus on the biochip.
What could cyberspace's watchers and protectors offer him? Intelligence on his enemies?
That doesn't matter in the least. Because you'll make sure the transaction never happens, and I get the chip.
Wait, neutral Netwatch is mixed up in this.
Netwatch provides net security for all corporations, and collects eddies in the millions for it. But in this day and age, everyone's in the game. And no one can afford to be a saint. To win, one has to go all in.
Fine. So no Arisaka security on the device because Yorinobu whisked it away in secret. Now, where's he hiding it?
Likely in a specialized container. One that mimics an organic neural environment. On the outside, it looks like an ordinary briefcase.
And the case is...
You'll see for yourself soon enough. provided we're done gossiping about the Arasakas.
Okay, what's next?
Now comes the best part. Follow me.
Got something for you. Should help you plan. Brain dance from Compecky Plaza.
How's a brain dance supposed to help? Need facts, not thrills.
I think BDs are only good for fondling virtual tits. Jacking off to in those boxes. No. It can be a very useful tool. Good for analyzing details, human perception, even boosted.
Sorry,
grasp.
I didn't mean to.
Exactly.
I'll do whatever I can to fix it.
So what's on the tape?
Yorinobu's suite. The glorious interior. You'll need to locate the relic yourself. Hope I grabbed enough detail to make that possible.
Kiss my dead spunk!
Hold up. Mean to say you recorded this?
Mm-hmm. BD rec implant. Why, you object?
Supposed to be Yorinobu's pad on the tape. Means you were inside. You know each other?
How else could I get all this intel? I know him pretty well, actually. We have an arrangement. Strictly business. Suits us both, I think.
Let's see this brain dance.
Judy'll help. She's a Mox, too. Besides, we go back, years. V, this is important. Judy's always been there for me.
Of course.
Always helped out.
It'll be just like you say.
I trust her. Mm. But she's
a
Mox, not the latest member of your crew.
Yeah.
Try not to forget. So, you'll be a good boy, tread lightly, and keep that tongue on a leash.
Relax. Believe it or not, I'm no stranger to tact. In biz or life.
He's here for that BD role. And V, this is Judy. Best brain dance editor I know.
Enough already. Gonna make me barf.
Sensory SIG amps, acoustic and emotive wave monitors. It's top shelf hardware.
Yeah, most of it's customized. Only thing factory are the casings.
Mod all this yourself?
What do you think?
Expression translator. Fuyutsuki, right? I thought the matrices on that series were fucked up.
They were, but swapping out matrices is simple. And this was the only model that'd support additional scanware.
All right.
Compiled your BDF.
What do you think? Will it do?
Still pretty raw. But yeah, ought to do.
Mm-hmm. V needs to get deep inside. That's most important.
So, let's calibrate. Tune it to him. Believe me, I've dealt with worse. Should see the jig-jig street porn we gotta contend with sometimes.
So, we drop V inside. Let him look, let him rummage around, right?
How about it, V? Raw brain dance. Ever taken a dip before?
Look, I'm no BD virgin, but the raw stuff? Uncharted territory.
Relax, I'll explain everything. It's less complicated than it sounds. Sit down, settle in, and we'll get you going. Create your sensory profile first.
Okay. Hit me. Just promise me it won't hurt.
It won't. Not this time. Now sit still, look at me. Gonna run the analysis soft. Should feel a slight tingling.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, now let's set the optics and other sensory sigs. Look smack into these two screens. Pretend it's an eye exam.
Get a lot of requests like this?
All the time. But it's usually stuff the girls scroll at the club. I take that and do some routine porn tuning.
Crank up the orgasms?
More like cut out all the other shit. Fucking's business as usual for these guys. Their minds wander to grocery lists, spouses' birthdays, late bills, whatever. But even then, you can refigure things, mold the emotions into something unique, unforgettable. So, I can't complain. One more sec. Need to get the pain receptor limiters in. Okay, all set. You need to test your profile first, tossing in a sample BD. You can use it to get to know the editor. Now let me see, where could we...
Can't he just use my recording? Why are we wasting time?
So we don't risk our necks? Besides, won't take a sec. Got something here. Should be perfect.
What'd you choose?
Corner store hold up in Haywood. Real amateurs. Don't even know where I got it. Suits our needs perfectly, though. You ready?
Boot it up.
Mm-hmm. Let me give you the tailored version first. Let you get your bearings. Then we'll jump into editing. Be diving in 3, 2, 1.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out. And we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
And remember, everything on full blast. They'll spot us extra for a wicked adrenaline high. Okay, on you go.
Everybody! On the ground! I want to see you kissing the flooring! Money! Now! Or I will fucking drop you, I swear to God!
Whoa! Yeah! Hey!
Now! Before I blow your fucking head off!
Happened. You're alive and well.
That flash of intense shock. I can still feel it, I remember. Fuck, that last second. You could have warned me how much it hurts to die.
Trust me, real death hurts much, much more.
Not so sure about that.
You'll be fine. Got everything set up? Let's switch over to editing mode.
I'll sever the link to the BD Roller's sensory array. You'll be able to look around freely. Whole scene's yours. Full cam control in analysis mode, so move around, zoom in and out, whatever else you come up with. Think of it as your own little sandbox. So, analysis mode, you control playback. Can even pause when you feel the need. Then you use the editor console to unpause. Try it.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out, and we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
Dream as hell, right? Well, that's not all. You can speed things up or rewind, whatever you like.
Give it a try. Rewind. Roll it back to the top. All good. Neat. Now try fast forwarding a bit.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. You go in, snatch the cash, yeah. But the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Okay. You can also reset the recording. That'll take you right back to the beginning. Try it. Now for some fun. This here's why you came in the first place. In analysis mode, you get to view and even scan details of the enviro recorded by the BD roller. Focus on the heat. The gun this gonk gets from his buddy at the beginning. Now scan it.
Plan simple. Do nothing odd. Don't get creative. You go in, snatch the cash, get out. And we sell the BD to those psycho freaks from the studio.
Got it.
And remember, everything on full blast.
Okay, right here. Analysis mode, you can ferret out background noise and conversations if the roller got close enough. This tech records everything, every little detail, even the sights and sounds the roller was never aware of. To see the sources of the recorded sensory signals, switch to the audio layer in the editor. Go ahead and try that now. Okay, good. Now you should see several sound signatures in the store. Choose one and hone in on it.
Pack of cigs, case of brosif, and a couple of zappers.
Okay, we have with you today on two flavors, curry and
serpentine. Everybody!
So, any thoughts?
Unbelievable. Seriously, like it was happening right next to me.
Yeah, it's how BD recording implants work. They pick up everything, all the elements in the background. Then an editor tweaks them, makes them pop. Keep playing with the sound, explore it a bit. We'll move on when you get bored. Sometimes you can analyze extra layers in the raw, stuff the roller's cyberware picked up.
Like what?
Ev's got Kiroshi optics that grab infrared, meaning you should be able to grab heat signatures from her recording.
Huh. Hella nice.
Now let's wait till the guy punches out the gonk at the counter.
On the ground! What, I see you kissing the flooring! Money!
Scanning works on peeps, too. Walk up to the wounded chick. Try scanning her. All right, next thing. Scroll forward to the part where our artist gets a lead injection.
Now, or I will fucking drop you! I swear to God! Whoa, you hit enough! Enough!
See that? They shot him and he never saw it coming. But you will. Here it comes. My favorite part of the game. See the blinking thing over the entrance? Surveillance cam. Must have caught our shooter. You'll see in a sec. Cam feeds to the screen behind the clerk. Roll back to where the screen's in the kid's field of vision, then scan it. His own Chumba shot him. Probably planned to all along. Must have got a nice slice of cred on the black market for a BD like this. BD freaks are ready to pay a preem for a real flatline. Anyway, if you've seen enough, you can exit.
Yeah,
expensive, right? It's too bad most of the BDs we do here are only good for flogging the log. Anyway, you ready to do this? Look at your wreck?
Dunno, I... Let's take a break. Still feel like that kid when... Oh, yeah. Think I'm done.
V, there's no time. Get it together, please.
Okay. Okay. Go ahead. Just need T-Bug to link in.
Whoa, whoa, whoa. Who?
Running for my crew. Security specialist. She'll tell me what to look for while we analyze. No problem, I hope.
Actually, it is a problem. Not what we agreed, Ev.
Evelyn, I won't get a damn thing out of this without T-Bug.
Judy, please.
Ev, he wants to bring a runner in? What part of that don't you understand? How do I know she'll only perch in this footage, observe, not fuck with anything?
Me. I'm your guarantee.
Yeah, right.
Help me. This one last time. I promise everything will work out, just like we planned.
Okay, V. Call T-Bug and we'll dive in.
Hey, V. What's happening?
Bug, listen. I got some useful footage from Compecky Plaza. It's a brain dance.
Compecky? Oh, thought as much.
Someone there with you?
Judy and Evelyn, they're chill. They're helping me work through this BD.
Uh-huh. All right. You gonna tell me what this is about?
Listen, need your help. Got no clue what to look for once I'm in.
All right, see if I can walk you through it. Jacking into your tech now. You've gotta give me access. Opening port 1779. Secure protocol? Good, I'm going in. Should be getting my request... now.
Got it. You ready?
A millisec. Okay, connection confirmed. Now some quick tip ice, and we're clear. Ready to dance.
Fire up, Judy.
Eyes open. Gotta find out where Yurinobu's keeping the relic.
You look like a cut of fuckable meat. Are you?
Evelyn. She... I felt her fear. Sure got it under control quick, too.
I said no.
They'll have my head for this.
Then, you shall perish for a good cause.
But,
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute to...
Listen in on that conversation, V. Could be something important.
I need a minute to finish.
The program is still in the trial phase. We cannot take it to market as is.
We shall see soon enough.
Please speak with your father. He's taken a particular interest in this project. He can certainly explain the risks.
My father's a tired, visionless old graybeard who thinks nothing will change and he'll live forever in his tiny frozen bubble.
I should not even be listening to such things.
You will listen to this. Saburoi is an adult despot, utterly removed from reality, stuck in some fossilized vision of a world that no longer exists, of a world that may never have existed. We have not seen eye to eye for the past 20 years. I am quite sure we want now.
Read the documentation carefully. The relic requires specific storage conditions. You must provide them.
Heard that? Relic docs gotta be around here somewhere. Look for them.
one!
Alarm firmware's fresh, but saw excited birds chirping on a BBS. Something about lots of seeds falling to this sieve. Let me generate keys. I can forge their six. Shit, camera's packed with new tech. Motion sensors, heat sig activators, IFF.
You skilled enough to kill it all?
Mucho more than enough. Just need access to their subnet. Hearing a drone. Ventilation and cooling? Servers. Gotta be. Fancy doodads in here need to be controlled.
But
make yourself comfortable. I need a minute to finish.
The program is still in the trial phase. We cannot take it to the
tiny, frozen bubble.
I should not even be listening to such things.
We'll listen to this. Sabroi is an adult despot.
Wow, champagne's
utterly
decent.
Removed from reality.
Taste boosted somehow?
Stuck in
nope,
some fossilized vision of a world
same bubbly you'll
that
be sipping
no
in real space
exists.
Soon.
Of a world that may never have existed. We have not seen eye to eye for the past 20 years. I am quite sure we want now.
Read the documentation carefully. The relic requires specific storage conditions. You must
no,
provide them.
Enough. Sorry to make you wait. Business can be stupid.
It wasn't long. Not even long enough for me to grow bored. Is everything all right? You seem tense. Edgy.
A moment. It will pass.
I can get to work on that. Just one condition.
You wish to make demands of me?
Only one. Focus. Oh, got any candy left? Stuff was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom. Nightstand.
I've got an idea. Be right back.
Very nice. But come here already.
Just a sec. Looking for the perfect thing. Ah. You'll like this.
What love is until you've learned the meaning of the world.
Any candy left? Stuff was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom, no dip.
Yeah, that's a little beer, but.
Automated turrets. Latest scanner model. Systems all connected to the server.
Can you shut them off?
Externally? No way. Gotta get in, check out how they link into the system first. Mm-hmm. Looks like all their security systems are linked to the hotel subnet. We need the flathead. No other way to shut down these systems.
Can't get around them ourselves?
Nope. At least I'm fresh out of ideas.
Oh, got any candy left?
Loaded. Safety's on. Good to know, though. Once you're in there, don't forget about that iron.
Mm-hmm.
Manual details a special temp-controlled container. Relic needs to be kept real cool.
So, chip's gotta stay in the freezer.
Yep, could damage it otherwise. Okay, switch on thermal layer detection in the editor. Should be easier to spot where your Nobu's keeping the chip. Air conditioning, standard model for hotels of this caliber. Temp matches that stipulated in the docks, but no way the chip's hiding there. Too risky. Temp fluctuations, risk of damage.
Got any candy left? Steph was pretty fun last time. Yeah, that's how I love you. She's big melon. Is everything all wrong with your vest?
Oh, Donaghy's. Looks like Mr. Arasaka had something to celebrate. Really think you'll find the chip in there? No way. Temp's too low. Could fluctuate. Nice try, though. Just a fancy-ass fridge. Temp doesn't match the guidelines. Won't find a thing here. Right, grab the heat sig. Matches the spec in the docks.
Yorinobu's got the case here. Guaranteed.
Mm-hmm. We got it. Good work. Looks like we got everything we need. Quit out of the editor.
Still in the trial phase. We cannot take it much as easily.
Focus. Got any candy? You left? Steph was pretty fun last time.
Bedroom. Nightstand.
I've got an idea. Candy left? Steph was pretty fun.
It's like I'm really...
B, eye on the prize. Focus.
Warui kome. I miss this. You.
I know.
Get everything you need?
Yep, that'll do. Thanks, Judy. We got it. Later, T-Bug.
Nice work today. See you soon.
I'll wipe the cache and your data. You were never here.
Keep it. I'll put it on Ev's tab. Portable device for handling BDs. I already uploaded your calibration settings. Not as sophisticated as what we got here, but should do the trick.
And it keeps you out of harm's way. Clever.
Speaking of harm's way, know what I see looking at you? Walking, talking corpses.
Relax, I got it all under control.
If you fuck up and they come knocking on my door, Judy, relax. That's not gonna happen. Evelyn, please, no shortcuts. You go that route, City'll always win. So be careful.
Of course I will be. Besides, we'll talk in a bit.
V, one sec. Let's walk. Well, what do you think?
I see how you know so much about Yorinobu.
It's simple. Men like pillow talk a bit too much.
So it's just about the sex?
Biz. And biz only.
You sure Yorinobu doesn't expect this kind of move from you?
He's got no idea. Trust me. He's too busy with Netwatch to give me that kind of attention. Besides, even if some suspicion takes root in his mind, it shouldn't matter. He won't react in time. And that's something you'll handle, right?
So, what now?
V, do this job for me. I mean me alone. No splitting the payout with anyone else. No middlemen. No Dex.
You want to fuck over our fixer? I knew something was up.
Dex is a middleman. And a useless one at this point.
Evelyn, you don't mess with fixers. That's the one rule every merc in this city knows. And actually follows.
But if we're smart...
Doesn't matter. Mistake like that'll cost you your rep. And without a rep, you're nobody. You sure you want to do this?
Better ask yourself that question. Do you want to spend the rest of your days blasting scabs? Or become a legend overnight? Your choice.
If I agree, there'll be hell to pay, for sure.
I know. Whatever you decide, it stays between us. I can offer 50%. Eddie's enough to do whatever the hell you like.
I'll be finished. Dex won't forgive a dirt move like this.
Dex isn't the only fixer in town. But my offer's the only one you'll ever get.
Let me think about it.
Mm-hmm. If you need me, call. I'll send you my number.
Okay.
Good luck. Now go. I need a few words with Judy.
Thank you.
See if he...
How are things looking, Mr. V?
Turns out Evelyn's recording from Compeki was worth
what?
Our time.
Beautiful. T-Bug already...
You back. So then, did you all hear about that Arasaka aircraft carrier docked in Night City? Called Kujira, or the Whale. Apparently the Corp figured it wasn't safe in Japanese waters. Afraid some local fishermen might harpoon it for scientific research. But honestly, it's quite the power move. Wonder what Militech will respond with. Maybe Myers will fly a Rust Bucket B-17 Flying Fortress over Arasaka HQ. Oh, man, that is insensitive. I am so sorry. Where are my manners? President Myers, I mean, of course. Gotta respect the office.
Get everything you need?
Yep, that'll do. Thanks, Judy. We got it. Later, T-Bug.
Nice work today. See you soon.
I'll wipe the cache on your data. You were never here.
I'll put it on Ev's tab. Portable device for him. Not as sophisticated as well.
And it keeps...
Speak. Walk.
Relax. I got it all under control.
If you fuck... You... Besides...
One sec. Let's walk. Well, what do you think?
Think I...
It's simple.
So it's...
Bit.
You sure you...
Besides...
So?
V, do this job for... No deck.
You wanna fuck... Evelyn? Doesn't matter. You sh...
Better ask... Your choice.
If I... I'll be...
Deck...
Mm-hmm. If you need me, call. I'll send you my number.
Okay.
Good luck. Now go. I need a few words with Judy.
Looking, Mr. V.
For sure, okay?
Turns out Evelyn's recording from Compeki was worth our time.
Beautiful. T-Bug already called. Said she's working her mat and the flathead.
Nothing yet. On it now.
T-Bug says no chance of that chip without that bot. To work then, Mr. V.
She's rattling on about the bank stuff, yada, yada, yada. All the while, I'm angling to get a word in because I need her to cover for me that afternoon when I go to pick my daughter up from preschool. But it's chill, you know.
This guy's over there, whacked out, almost knocked over them all at the door.
He go apeshit inside?
Nah, get this. Shum says he wants real fun, real flesh, punching animal-like. No virtue shit. He knows it's not allowed, but he'll pay triple. So Gina, what she do? Drags the gonk back to a box.
Yeah,
guy's
yeah,
so high,
it.
He thinks the BD trolls are some fancy-ass toy. And Gina loads the
right,
orgy
Mom.
With the infinite loop orgasm at the end.
Nothing's wrong. Really.
Why don't you just tell me the truth?
I just told you.
I still feel like shit.
Little head of the dog.
Yeah. Give me a sec.
I'm off the clock, hon. I have a tiger, babe.
Hey.
Successful meeting?
Very. Hey, Mateo, how will you know Evelyn?
You know, in passing.
Please. You know I ain't buying that. She come here often. Evelyn.
She didn't tell you?
Didn't come up.
She comes around sometimes.
See Judy?
Maybe.
They close?
You know, been nice to chat. I gotta get back to work.
All right. Thanks for the chat. Thanks. Better get going.
Oh, problem.
money, I think. Tell the girls on the door. They will take care of it.
No.
It's my friend. She works 8th Street. Out of bounds. Not our zone.
I know, but she wants out.
Ma,
what a sweet little face you have.
Full time.
Come on in. There a problem?
Stout here. Start by telling me how you got this number.
No more than your number. Heard you misplaced a convoy.
You shut him up! Spill what you know. Don't make me wait.
Nuh-uh. Not on the horn. Let's meet. Cut a deal.
A deal? Fine. First exit off Skyline, driving towards the NID. Storm channel under the overpass. Meet you there.
Why don't you lick my ass, hey?
The client. Her name's Parker. Evelyn Parker.
Who is she? What's she like?
She's got friends in high places. Clouds like.
Well, so do we. We're working with Dex now.
Parker knows you're in Nobu Arasaka. They fuck.
Merda! Militech, what'd you decide?
We agreed to have a face-to-face, so we'll see.
KV, just keep an eye out, okay? Waiting for you at all foods, you know? Not getting any younger.
Thank you.
Look lively. Meredith Stout. Take it you were the one to call?
That'd be...
Thought you could blackmail me, fucker? Set conditions? Got any more for me?
Calm the fuck down, I just want to talk!
Christ, Meredith!
Shut your trap! That fucking thing ready?
All set.
Now answer my questions, honestly. Forthrightly. Are you here alone?
Yep, just little old me.
It's the truth.
Do a sweep, now. Now listen, this piece of shit, Anthony Gilchrist, is he your contact? Is he the one who leaked intel on the convoy?
Never met anybody named Gilchrist. That the poor fucker right there?
It's true. Doesn't know him.
That said, I've jumped a few convoys in my day. Know all the usual suspects. Bet I can help find your mole. But what I know now won't get you anywhere in that respect. Listen, I know where the transport is. I can help you. Just want a favor in return.
I told you! I fucking told you! I'm not the mole! Jesus Christ!
Shut him up!
Unhand me now before I...
Him you can let go. Wanna hear what he has to say.
You know, I could help patch the gaps in your convoy security. Prevent a repeat of this fiasco.
Nope, not interested.
Let's hear your offer. I don't have all day.
Couldn't have been chill from the start.
Shut the fuck up. Tell me what you want.
I need a bot. Flathead model. Guys who ripped you off have it. Promise me that bot. I'll point the finger.
You have a plan how to deal with them?
Could just take it by force, but they're expecting payment. So I could go that route too.
Fine, the latter. But on one condition. You pay with our money.
Solid enough. I'm in.
You pay with that chip, and that's all you gotta worry about. Try to fuck me in any way, and I'll be seeing you real soon.
You're making a mistake! The cubs are any good as dead! And she'll take you down with her!
famed televangelist Bryce Stone. I just got word his 12-year-old son has been killed. The NCPD says there wasn't much left to identify, let alone collect. I'm sorry. No punchline on this one, Night City.
Ah, there you are. These on the cred ship are clean. Thank you.
yeah, por fin. Let me hear what you squared away.
So Dex already paid the Maelstromers for the Corpo bot. Thing is, can't be sure the gang goons are still willing to hand it over.
He paid up front?
Híjole. Well, whatever. Let's go get this tech. You scheme yet? You got a plan?
Militech and me, we found some common ground. They're footing the bill for the bot.
There's a lot of scratch to toss away.
Forget it, Jack. It would be like we never had it in the first place. Anyway, who knows how this deal's gonna shake out.
So, into the Borg Beast Den?
Let's go see these bastards.
All right, let's knock on their door. See if they even open up.
I hate these Borg fuckers. Just had to be them.
Just a gang like any other, right?
I'll take the Valentinos. They follow God and the Santa Madre. Honor means something to them. You know what they want, how they get it, and what pisses them the fuck off.
With Maelstrom, you just never know.
Go on, let them know we're here.
Don't know you.
Want to talk to Royce. Dex sent us.
Main room. We've been waiting.
Cozy place. They could use a few plants, though.
Oh, yeah.
They look damn well prepared.
Don't think I've ever seen security like this in a chow factory.
Gear from the Jack convoy. Gotta be. Must have been all over it like maggots on dead meat.
That's Militech, all right.
Psycho board scrolled out of the blue. Hey, what was in there?
A Militech truck.
But those cabrones only swiped a couple crates. Not a whole fucking semi.
Anti-personnel mine. Directional shrapnel spitter. My favorite.
Subtle. Stay cool. They're just trying to spook us. Fucking sheep.
we're on their turf.
So what do you want?
You got a bot. Model MT0D12. Called the Flathead.
And? The hell you care?
Guy I represent already paid brick for it. I'm just here for the pickup. I can talk direct to Royce if necessary.
Nah, you talk to me. Name's Tum Tum. Now couch, planet.
Ain't gonna end well, but shit.
Well, all right. Come on, got lighten up. Take a hit.
What is it?
Skeef. Shit kicks you in the ass.
It's a fucking rush, man. Gotta feel it for yourself. Come on, give it a whirl.
Tech's not gonna come looking for it?
Fuck 'em. They can hop around and try. We removed the serial number and lifted access locks using our soft. What's yours, it's yours.
Need to see it.
Sue yourself. Fucking tricked out, this thing. Dynamic thermo-optic camo armor. Full cognitive immersion with a Raven controller. Pimped out prototype actuators made of titanium vanadium Kevlar composite. And watch this! Fully integrated link too, so when the spider starts crawling up walls dangling from ceilings.
Could lose your lunch.
So what you think?
Raven's not the dedicated control unit for a flathead.
Ha! Of course not! Militech controllers auto-link to Militech systems. I mean, you wouldn't want them tracking their stolen tech back to your hands. Yeah, Raven's our baby. Got improved neural sync and no fucking pesky tracing. You ask me, we ought to sell that shit.
Yep, we'll take it.
Free. Sure. Yeah. Let's see your cred.
Brick got it. It's all paid up.
Brick got it. I don't see any fucking brick around here, do you?
Ask. Fuck brick then. Let's cut a new deal.
Now that's good business sense. Alright, you want the flathead? I better see some eddies.
Relax. Got him right here.
Just like that! Without batting a fucking eye!
Want it or not, I got places to be.
You know, you never did say who sent you. Never did say who you're working for.
Dexter Deshawn. That's it.
Dexter Deshawn. The hard ass who punching animal fucked half of Pacifica? He ain't dead.
Here he is, the ugly bastard!
You're dead. You
hear?
I'm not on a field.
Come on!
Fuerte, cabrón!
Said, bot and controller. Production line. Plus, I thought you loved me.
Really, no other way.
Thank you.
Thank you.
far enough.
We can spot you.
Maelstrom, huh? Never ends well, does it? Looks like you two lucked out a bit.
What happened to Stout?
She placed some bad bets. Her clock ran out. Simple as that. Suffice to say, you won't be seeing her again.
And you? Why are you here?
Well, I still don't know who the mole is. I was hoping the Maelstromers would shed some light on it.
Yeah. I doubt that. Pretty tough to get corpses to talk.
You'd be surprised. I'm sure I'll manage something. It's been a pleasure.
Holy shit, V. I wasn't sure we'd walk out in one piece.
We make a good team, Jack.
I think you might be right.
In any case, I don't regret switching my life up the way I did.
Now that'd be the sweet taste of success, my friend. Hey, call up Dex, let him know we got his toy. Meeting to celebrate at the afterlife. Ahí luego, V.
How things looking, Mr. V?
Got the bot.
And how'd it go? Run into any troubles? And what about the Militech angle?
Sure, of course it was trouble. Royce couldn't have given two shits at you and Brickett shaking her.
How'd you get him on board? You used the Corpo woman?
Met with Stout, managed to strike a deal.
Well, well.
Gave me the chip with the scratch from Maelstrom.
So you paid for the flathead with Corp cash?
No. Decided I could use the Eddies myself. And I just grabbed the bot.
Just like that?
Not just. Had to use violence.
You got some balls, Mr. B.
We're all set. Ready to go. What now?
Now we do the job I hired you to do. Grabbing that biochip. We'll talk about the rest at the afterlife. See you there.
Great. Be there in no time.
See you, Mr. B.
Thank you.
ya tengo planes para esta noche. Santísima ma, te vas a enterar mañana.